Hello friends, my name is Ramasu. Today we shall discuss about topic the transmission control protocol TCP/IP. Friend, today's topic is very interesting, especially if you have interest in network security and networks and you want to learn about it. So let's start. First of all, I would request to please subscribe to my YouTube channel and click on the bell option as well so that my videos can reach to you, and also you can follow me on the Facebook page as well. Friend, TCP/IP, first we talk about TCP. So TCP stands for Transmission Control Protocol. Basically, it's a protocol which we use by applications and computing devices to exchange data over the network. Like if there are two applications, for example, application A and application B, and they want to exchange the data over the network, over the internet, so they can use the TCP protocol. Now TCP protocol, what actually they do, the TCP protocol divide the data into smaller packets and transfer the data over the network in by dividing the data into smaller chunks. These small chunks are called as small packets, and TCP transmission control protocol also ensure that the data should be integrated. Like there should not be any problem, and the full data, after dividing the data into the packets, the full data should be transferred from source location to the destination location. The best example of the TCP protocol is the file transfer protocol FTP, secure shell SSH, telnet, also access protocol IMAP, post office protocol POP, and simple mail transfer protocol SMTP, and for web access through the hypertext transfer protocol HTTP. Like the emails which you are receiving, they are using the SMTP protocol, which is based on the TCP protocol. Now the other part of the TCP protocol is the IP. So IP is basically called as Internet protocol. Internet protocol is the method for sending data from one device to another across the internet, and every device has an IP address that uniquely identifies it and enables the communication with or exchange data with other devices connected to the internet. IP, Internet protocol, is responsible for defining how applications and devices exchange packets of data with each other. It is the principal communication protocol responsible for the formats and rules for exchanging data and messages between computers on a single network server, internet connected network. It does this through the Internet Protocol Suite, TCP/IP, a group of communication protocol that are split into four abstraction layer. Now here is the question that how actually the TCP/IP works. Friend, if you just see this diagram, this is a very simple diagram to explain the TCP/IP protocol. For example, this is the source location and this is the destination location. That means from the source location you want to send a data to the destination location. So if you are using the TCP/IP protocol, TCP connection would be established between source and the destination, and then the data will be divided into smaller chunks that are called as packets, and then these packets are transferred over the internet from source location to destination location. And when they are sending from the source location, these packets, smaller chunks, are divided into smaller packets, and once they are receiving on the destination side, these packets will be reassembled to become a complete data. So here important thing is that once the TCP/IP protocol is basically dividing the data into smaller chunks, the data integrity, they will ensure that the data should not be there should not be any problem in the in the data, and the complete data with integration with integrated data should be reassembled on the destination side. So there should not be any problem in the data once we are transferring the smaller packets over the internet from source location to destination location. So friend, thanks a lot for watching the video. I hope you like this video. If you like it, please share it with your friends and colleagues.